guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Gloria. Thank you so much for clicking on today's video. Today I wanted to give you guys a little bit of a haul. So I got a few philodendrons and I just kind of wanted to show you guys. So if you guys enjoy these mini hauls, make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And yeah, let's get started with today's video. So the first plant I wanted to show you is a velvety philodendron, kind of more on the uncommon side slash rare. I don't really like to call plants rare, but yeah, I would say not a lot of shops have this one for some reason, and I found this through a website called GD Plants, which is located in the GTA area. So they do local pickup and also shipping, so via Canada Post and UPS, which is what I saw on their site. But I just opted out for the pickup option because I do live fairly close, so I figured why not. And this is the first one I wanted to show you guys. It's the Philodendron gigas. So this one is essentially like the Melanochrysum's cousin. So the leaves are so soft, so they're softer and more velvety than the Melanochrysum. The lobes of the ears are a little bit more rounded, so it's not as heart-shaped. But just look at this new leaf that just came out. And it recently unfurled, obviously not in my care because I just bought it, but you can see it's a slightly different color and there's kind of like an orangey sheen to it compared to the older leaves. So the older leaves kind of are more darker green, and that's the color that it will fade to over time. And yeah, you could just see through the camera how velvety these leaves are. And of course, they're not perfect leaves. There are like a little bit of damage here and there, but that comes with importing plants because these aren't grown in Canada, obviously. And yeah, I just gave this baby a little moss pole that I made myself. So it's a little DIY moss pole. I just used a bamboo stick and some moss, and I just wrapped it with some twine. I wrapped it with some white twine and just secured it with a knot, and then I just stuck it straight into the soil, and I think it looks really cute. I chose kind of like a smaller moss pole just because it's not really too big of a plant at the moment, and I think there's a long way for it to go. I do hear that the Philodendron gigas is a bit of a slow grower. I would really love for new leaves to come out in my care just to see like how it likes it in my home. I currently have it in my greenhouse and I think, you know, it's pretty happy, so hopefully it continues to be like that, and I'll definitely keep you guys updated. That was the first plant I got from GD Plants. So this one is the second plant that I got, and it's definitely not one of the typical philodendrons I usually go for. My other philodendrons that I have are my Gloriosum and my Melanochrysum, so more on the velvety soft heart-shaped leaves. But this one is a little different. So this is my Philodendron Bilietti. I think that's the official way to say it. So this is just the baby version. I have it in a little 4-inch pot that I repotted when I first bought it. I used the same soil just because, I don't know, it looked like the soil was fine to me when I took a look at it and I didn't see any pests. So I figured I'd just use the original soil. And the gigas that I bought, I didn't even repot it. I just put it inside a cover pot and let it acclimate to my environment first. But yeah, there's two beautiful leaves on this Bilietti, and the stems are like a darkish reddish orange, which is really cool. I just have a piece of Velcro kind of tying it together just so the leaves aren't, you know, hitting the bottom where the pot is sitting, because if I don't, then it kind of reaches the bottom, and it's because my pot is very shallow. I didn't really choose a very deep pot, and I don't really mind it because hopefully the Velcro will do the trick. But yeah, I see a new growth coming. So just right over there, there's a little bit of a new growth. So hopefully new leaves will come out and they will be just as big, if not bigger, than these current leaves, because I know the Bilietti can get really, really big. So yeah, this one's my little baby Bilietti, and I think I like this one more than the Atabab Poensi because that one has the red backs, but the stems on these are more unique. I think the Atabab Poensi is green, but correct me if I'm wrong. They do look very similar, and I know there's even a hybrid between the two. So, you know, plants get really complicated when there's so many different types, and I know it could be really overwhelming. But yeah, I'm really, really, really impressed with the plants that I got from GD Plants. And yeah, like, their website was really easy to use. I didn't have any problems. I didn't really even purchase during the initial launch of the website, so I probably did miss out on a bunch of the other plants that were there, but the ones that I got, I'm still pretty happy with. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I'll link the store that I bought it from down below so you guys can check it out. And yeah, thank you so much for watching, and I hope you guys enjoyed. Subscribe if you haven't done so already, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.